But anyways, guys, all right, so we are going to get into this Jon Jones story. Now, this story right here from Drew Beaupre at sportsillustrated.com 10 hours ago says, UFC news, Jon Jones could face jail time for alleged assault of drug testing agents. The UFC star is in hot water once again. Jon Bones Jones has dealt with a number of highly publicized legal issues throughout his storied fighting career, the latest of which occurred on March 30th when UFC drug testing agents from Drug Free Sport showed up at his home in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and were reportedly confronted by an uncooperative Jones. And something to note here is that people actually said he was drunk when this happened, so I don't know. But it was said that he was drunk. According to a report from Damon Martin, Jones has been charged with assault, petty misdemeanor assault, and an interference with communications, which is also a misdemeanor, and could face fines as well as jail time if he's convicted of both of the charges. The fines for both charges could total up to a whopping $1,500. In addition to jail time of less than a year, Jones is now scheduled for a virtual bond on July 17th, which is this week. This is far from the worst legal situation that Jones has faced in his career, but certainly not a good look for the 36-year-old as he continues to try and hype up fans for a matchup with Stipe Miocic that was originally supposed to happen at UFC 295 last year. That fight's never going to happen, or it will, and he'll retire, but the UFC has remained committed to rebooking Jones versus Miocic, even though interim heavyweight champion Tom Aspinall is scheduled to defend his title at UFC 304 this month. And more than a few fans have called Jones' status as heavyweight king into question, considering he returned from a three-year layoff to win the belt at UFC 285 and has not fought since. It remains to be seen whether or not Jones will be convicted for his behavior towards drug testing agents and how that may change plans for his fight with Miocic. But Bones did recently tease fans with a post claiming he'd be returning in November at Madison Square Garden. So that's the story from Drew Beaupre. It's just not, there's nothing new here. It's not, this story came out in March when it happened. Jon posted it on his Instagram showing him like walking the agents out or high-fiving them or something like that for the sake of defending himself, basically saying, look how cool this was. I high-fived them. And I remember I talked about this on stream at the time. And I said, if he was just somewhat threatening to you, but now you're getting an opportunity to leave safely. And he just goes, yeah, high five. Of course you're going to high five him. You're trying to get out of there safely. This is a guy that has a violent past and a criminal past, especially when he's under the influence of substances, and they say allegedly he might have been drunk during this. So I don't think anything's going to come of this. I do think that the UFC is going to ignore this, not acknowledge it, no statement whatsoever. Jon Jones is going to go pay some fine, no jail time, and we never hear about this again. Maybe he makes a payment to the USADA agents or Drug Free Sport International agents. But as a whole, it's nothing new from Jon Jones. It's to be expected, but it just stinks that this is the guy that Dana is deciding to prop up. Of all the champions that he could be promoting right now, Leon could be promoted better. Alex Pereira should be getting promoted better, for fuck's sake. Jon versus Stipe, the fight that none of us have asked for, is still going to happen. Tom Aspinall is probably going to fight the winner. Or what I think is going to happen is Jones is going to beat Stipe, retire. Whoever wins between Aspinall and Blades at 304 gets promoted to the undisputed champ, and that person will fight the winner of Cyril Gane and Alexander Volkov, which is now allegedly happening at UFC 308 in Abu Dhabi. Let me know what you guys think down below. Do you think that the UFC should move on from the stars of yesterday, like Jon Jones, Conor McGregor, especially with all the trouble that they get into? Or do you think that they should hang on to and squeeze every last bit of profit and pay-per-view sale that they can? So let me know in the chat. Hey guys, thanks for watching this video. Make sure to click like and subscribe down below, all that YouTube stuff. It really helps me out a lot. If you're interested in supporting the channel further and want access to members-only perks, become a channel member today for access to members-only live streams and some other perks. Link is in the description down below, or just click the join button on our channel homepage. If you're looking for some non-MMA content from me, go check out my personal channel, Wyatt's World. I'll have that linked in the description down below as well. Go watch this suggested video, and I'll see you next time.